Alright, what's up guys? Welcome back to another Dokkan Battle video. So, with this year's download celebration rapidly approaching, it's time for us to do something that we've done on this channel every single year, at least for the last 2 years, and that is to try our best to predict how many free download celebration tickets we can all expect to get once this campaign officially begins, specifically on the global side, since I did base this video off the global campaigns, although I feel like the JP ticket count shouldn't be that far off. Maybe. Anyways, before we jump into it, I do want to give the biggest of shoutouts to my guy Tony from Discord for all the hard work and time that he put in to helping me collect the data that we're about to use in this video. This was really a collaborative effort between the two of us. And man, Tony, if you're watching this right now, I just want to say, man, I really appreciate you. Okay, so with that said, let's get down to business. And the first thing I want to do here is give people a quick explanation about how this stuff actually works, especially for the newer players who maybe haven't been through a download celebration before. And basically, every year at the beginning of each download celebration, Bandai gives out download celebration tickets to every single player based on the total number of stones that they spent in the previous year or since the last time that tickets were distributed. And these tickets can be used on a special download celebration banner like the one you see on the screen right now. Now this was from last year, obviously the one for this year will be a little bit different, but the concept should be the same. And as you can see, these banners usually include almost every single Dokkan Festival exclusive units in the entire game, with the exception of the LRs, as well as some of the newer units. So I believe for last year's banner, the newest unit was this guy right here, the Fizz Future Gohan. So using this as a reference, I feel like the most recent or newest unit we'll see on this year's banner is probably the Tech Trunks and the AGL Zamasu, like that dual Dokkan Fest. Maybe Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken Goku as well, and I think units like Transforming Cooler and AGL Bardock and all those guys that came out after the new year are pretty unlikely, although they could surprise us, so we'll see. But either way, that's the banner right there. And also in the unfeatured pool, there's gonna be some LRs. So last year there were units like LR Bardock, LR Beerus, LR Bojack. I think there were around 10 LRs in total, and obviously this year we should be getting some newer LRs, maybe everybody up until Killing Khalifa, possibly. But once again, we'll see, because I can't say for sure, but there are going to be some LRs in this banner that are also available to be pulled. So that's what the banner is going to look like, and like I said, it's based on the total number of stones that you spent in the previous year. So for every 50 stones that you spent, you'll get one ticket. So if you spent 1,000 stones, for example, then that's 20 tickets, 2,000 stones, 40 tickets, and so on and so forth. And that's why, in today's video, in order to try to predict how many free tickets we can expect to get, me and Tony from Discord have collected all the free-to-play stone data from every single global campaign since the last time that tickets were given out. And once we add up all these numbers from all the campaigns and divide by 50, that should tell us exactly how many free tickets we should all expect to get for this campaign. Granted, if you did everything, right? Like if you got all the logins, did all the missions, completed all of the new events, and also spent all those stones. So of course there is gonna be some variance from player to player, right? For example, if you're pay to play and you do buy stones on top of the free to play stones, then you will be getting more tickets than, you know, what I say here. And if you maybe missed some stuff in between or took a break from the game during this year, then you'll be getting less tickets. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. I know it was a super long explanation, but I just wanted to make sure that everybody was on the same page before we got started. And if you guys have any questions about how this stuff works, or you know, were confused by my explanation, then feel free to ask a question in the comments down below, and I'll try my best to get to it. Okay, so with all that said, now let's jump into this stone count here, and we're gonna start from the 300 million download celebration, which of course was last year's download celebration. And in total, from this campaign, between the countdown and parts 1 and 2, we got 1,000 and 70 free Dragonstones. Now, I don't have a full breakdown here, but there is one in yesterday's video, so feel free to go check that out through the link above my head. And that was, of course, the Dual Dokkan Fest between the AGL Gohan and Int Cell, as well as the top legendary summon banner with the LR Androids. Now, moving on from there, the next campaign that was on Global was for the Transforming Namek Goku. It was called Wrathful Outburst Showdown on Planet Namek. And for the login bonus, we got 19 stones. For the missions, we got 31. For the Dokkan event, we got 2. We also got the Legendary Goku event missions for 46 stones, 29 stones from the Frieza story event, 32 from the second form Frieza Extreme Z Awakening, 31 from a new Ultimate Clash. And we also got the Hercules Heart Pounding Gifts, which of course is a little bit random since it's all based on RNG and some people got lucky and got a lot more stones than other people. But if you were really, really unlucky like I was and only got one stone per day from this, you still got a minimum of 10 stones from it. And then there was the Buhan Extreme Z Awakening, which was 34 stones, and also a survey for the 300 million download celebration, which gave 10 stones. So we add all that up, and from this campaign right here, we got 214 stones. And then moving on to the terror-stricken Dokkan Halloween campaign, which was the campaign that had the full power Frieza legendary summon banner. So 22 stones from login, 33 from missions, 7 from the SOS to the Fortune Teller story event, or basically the Kid Saiyaman event. And then 3 more stones from a new stage of the Ghostly Prank event plus mission. And also 3... Oh, what'd I do there? There we go. And then 3 more stones from the new stage for the Trick or Treat event plus the mission. And then also 34 stones from the Legendary Super Saiyan Broly Extreme Z Awakening. And also 19 more stones from the Legendary Super Saiyan Story Renewal. You add all those up, that's 121 stones from the Halloween campaign. And then we had the Dokkan Thank You Celebration, which brought in these guys for part 1, the Trunks as well as the Zamasu. And for part 2, I believe we just got this top legendary summon banner. So it was 351 stones for part 1, 160 for part 2, for a grand total of 511. Now there's not a specific breakdown here, but I think it should be okay. And then after that, there was the Christmas campaign. So the Christmas campaign was this banner right here, the Tanabata banner from JP, as well as the LR Kale and Khalifa banner, and also the Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken Goku banner right here. So for part 1, we got 143 stones. For part 2, we got 118 stones. And then there was also a end of year mission slash login thing that gave us 25 stones. So you add those up, 286 stones for the Christmas campaign. And then after that, of course, there was the New Year's campaign, which I believe brought the Piccolo and was there somebody else? Piccolo and oh, also the Dragon Ball Heroes crossover. So starting with the Piccolo stuff, for the first login, we got 20 stones. For daily logins, 36 stones in total. All missions gave us 41 stones. Top grossing rewards for 40 stones. And then 2 stones from the Piccolo event, 3 stones from the Prime Battle LR Cell event, and 34 stones for the SDR Cell Extreme Z Battle for 176. And then for the Dragon Ball Heroes World Mission crossover, there were 17 stones for login, 12 for missions, 6 from the Prism Planet Saga story event, and then 31 from a new Virtual Dokkan Ultimate Clash for a total of 66. And then we're going to move on to the Master and Disciples Desperate Counterattack campaign, which was for the Int Transforming Gohan or Future Gohan here. And for logins, we got 14 stones. For special missions, we got 23. For the LR Vegito Blue campaign, which was Vegito Blue's legendary campaign, we got 30 stones. Obviously, this is going to be different for different people because some people maybe didn't get him done before the campaign started, so this would be 20 stones in that case. And then for the Beacon of Hope, or, you know, the new Dokkan event, essentially, for the Int Gohan, 2 Dragon Stones. And then there was the renewal for the Fight Against Despair story event plus missions for 26 stones. Extreme Z area for the Int Super Saiyan Trunks, 3 stones right there. 7 unit Extreme Z Awakening, 37 stones. And also the Super Saiyan Blue Kaioken Goku Extreme Z Awakening for 34 stones, a grand total of 169 stones for that campaign. After that, we had the Filled with Energy Max Power Reinforcement campaign. Well, these campaigns have some crazy names, and that was for this dude right here. The Int LR Super Saiyan God Goku campaign, or the banner here. And the login was 14 stones, special missions 22 stones. Hercule's Heart Pound and Gifts lasted for 2 weeks, so a minimum of 14 stones. Obviously, if you got lucky, then you could be getting a lot more stones for that as well. And 31 stones for a new Ultimate Clash, 34 for the Fizz Vegito Blue Extreme Z Awakening, 50 for the first set of Legendary Goku Event category missions, and then 14 for hitting top grossing in, I'm pretty sure, 2 regions. And we're looking at 178 stones for this campaign. And then after that, we had the SDR Transforming Cooler banner, as well as his campaign, of course. 16 stones for login, 25 for special missions, 2 from his Dokkan event, 17 for the renewal of the Strongest Rival story event plus missions, 9 from the Hero Extermination Plan Extreme Z area, 34 for STR Omega Shenron's Extreme Z Awakening, 53 for a new world tournament, and then also 7 for achieving first place in one region, probably France, but I'm not 100% sure, 163 stones for this campaign. And then after that, we had the AGL Transforming Bardock Saiyan Day campaign. So 13 stones for the first login, 26 for the total login bonus after that, 48 for special missions, 2 from Bardock's Dokkan event, 10 from the Team Bardock special event, 31 from the Ultimate Clash that came with the campaign, 18 for a Facebook campaign, and 30 for hitting top grossing on Bardock's banner, 178 stones for this campaign. And then from there, Extreme Clash Ultimate Power Up. Oh, it was for Android 13's campaign. Okay, so 18 for login, 27 for special missions, 2 from his Dokkan event, 16 for the Android 13 story event, 30 from the LR Cell campaign, 34 from the AGL Super Vegito Extreme Z Awakening, 31 for the Ultimate Clash that came with this campaign, 17 for the April Fool's Day apology, and also 8 from the Bulma's Wild Chase story event, 183 stones for Android 13's campaign. And then after that, there's the Spring in Full Bloom Spring Training campaign, which brought over the LR Spirit Bomb Absorb Goku on this Rising Dragon Carnival Double Rates banner. We got 18 stones for logins, 29 for special missions, 6 from the second set of Hero Extermination Extreme Z area units, and also 11 minimum for the Hercule Heart Pounding Gifts. Of course, once again, if you got lucky, you could get more, but this is for 1 stone per day from this login bonus. And then 34 from the Tech Merge Zamasu Extreme Z Awakening, 7 more for hitting top grossing for 105 stones. After that, there was the Gohan, Goku, and Goten Day campaign, and this one was actually pretty significant. So the first part brought over the Dual Dokkan Fest between this Super Saiyan 2 Vegeta and this Super Saiyan 2 Angel Goku, who both transform, of course, into Majin Vegeta and Super Saiyan 3 Angel Goku, respectively. And then for part 2, it was... what was it again? Oh! How could I forget? The Legendary Summon Banner for the Global First LR Ultra Instinct Goku. So, for this campaign, we got a countdown login bonus for 5 stones, and the login bonus for the actual campaign was 70 stones, 52 stones for the special missions for all parts, 2 stones for Majin Vegeta's Dokkan event, 2 stones for Super Saiyan 3 Goku's Dokkan event, 23 stones for the World Tournament Reborn story event, 23 for the Infinite Dragon Ball History stage versus Goku's family plus missions, and then 23 more stones for the Vegeta's family stage, 45 from the Legendary Goku event missions, 31 for the 19th Dokkan Ultimate Clash, 36 from the Destined Rival Saga Extreme Z Awakening for the STR Majin Vegeta and the Super Saiyan 2 Angel Goku, and then 9 stones from the 3rd set of Hero Extermination Plan Extreme Z Awakenings, 15 stones from a Facebook campaign, 7 stones for hitting top grossing, I believe, on the first 2 banners, 34 stones for the AGL Rose Goku Black, Extreme Z Awakening event, and then 35 more stones for hitting top grossing for the LR UI Goku banner. So that's 412 stones in total from the Goku, Gohan, and Goten Day celebration this year. And then beyond that, we had the celebration for this Fizz Beerus called Transcending Dimensions Battle of Gods campaign. 14 stones for login, 29 for special missions, 2 from Beerus's Dokkan event, 21 for the Battle of Gods story event renewal, 3 stones from the Prime Battle Krillin event, 31 for the Ultimate Clash, and 34 stones for Int Super Saiyan Blue Vegeta's Extreme Z Awakening, 134 stones total for Beerus's campaign. And then lastly, before we go into the anniversary, which we're currently still on technically, we had this little filler celebration with the Legendary Summon banner for LR Vegeta and Nappa. And all we got for this were 15 stones for the login bonus, 29 for the special missions, and 34 for the Int Spirit Sword Trunks Extreme Z Awakening, 78 stones in total for this little filler campaign. And now we have the anniversary, and let's just start with part one here. Okay, so in part one, or sorry, no, let's start with the countdown first. For the countdown, we got 10 stones for the social media thank you present, 20 for the comeback campaign, 10 for daily login, 53 for the world tournament, 15 for a countdown quiz, and 3 for maintenance compensation. That's 111 stones for the countdown alone, which is comparable to actually a lot of these other campaigns, so that's pretty awesome. And then for part one, in part one we had 45 stones for the initial login bonus, 140 for all the login bonuses, 35 for the daily missions, 11 for the special missions in part one, 35 for the new boss rush, 10 for the blue liquid campaign, 35 for the Frieza's army enlistment test, 7 stones for the first part of the Saiyan trio led by Fate story event plus missions, 8 stones for the first part of the Zero Mortals plan story event plus missions, 31 stones for the new Dragon Ball Super Broly movie themed Infinite Dragon Ball History stage, 1 for the Whis training event, 4 for Gogeta and Vegito's Dokkan events, 40 for the new Ultimate Clash, 13 stones for the Double God social media campaign, 20 more for another social media campaign, 10 more stones for another social media campaign, and then finally, top grossing rewards for the Dual Dokkan Fest, 100 stones right there, total of 545 stones in part 1. And then for part 2, we got 12 stones for special missions, 9 for the Zero Mortals plan new stages and missions, 6 for the Saiyan trio led by Fate new stages plus missions, 6 for the Kid Vegeta and Raditz and Kid Broly Extreme Z Awakening or Extreme Z area, 10 stones for the Dragon Ball Hunt campaign, 20 stones for the Save Broly social media campaign, 30 stones for hitting top grossing on Google Play, 12 stones for Golden Weekend missions, and 14 more for top grossing on the LR Broly and Rosé banner. So 119 stones for part 2. And then for part 3, which is currently still on at the time I'm filming this video, we got 21 stones for the special missions, 7 for the Zero Mortals plan Extreme Z Awakening plus missions, and then 31 for the new Future Saga Infinite Dragon Ball History stage, total of 59. You add all those parts up, the countdown plus parts 1, 2, and 3, and for the anniversary, we got a grand total of 834 Dragon Stones, which is pretty freaking solid. Obviously, not as good as the download celebration, but still really, really significant. Okay, so those are all the campaigns that have already happened on Global since the last time that tickets were given out. Obviously, the highlights are the last download celebration. 1,070 stones is still crazy to me. And then we also had the thank you celebration, which gave out 511 stones. The Goku, Gohan, and Goten Day celebration was also pretty significant, which gave out, what was it, 412 stones. And then, of course, we had the anniversary with 834. Now, there is going to be one more campaign on a global before this next download celebration happens. Obviously, at this point, we don't really know what it's going to be, but I do have a strong suspicion that it's going to be the Kefla campaign from JP, and if that's the case, then we should be expecting 32 stones for logins, 58 from the special missions, and also daily missions, 21 minimum for the Hercules Heart Pounding Gifts, 2 from the Transforming Kefla Dokkan event, 1 from the Warriors of Universe 6 story event, the new stage with the skill orbs, 26 from a new Infinite Dragon Ball History stage, 31 from the new Virtual Dokkan Ultimate Clash, 6 from the AGL Cooler and Int Frieza Extreme Z area, 1 for the Trial for New Domain event, and 33 for the Kale and Caulifla Extreme Z Awakening or Extreme Z Battle event. Now I do have some confidence, not a lot, but some confidence that we could get top grossing for this banner as well, which would mean, you know, another 7, 14, maybe 21 stones. So we could potentially bump this up to 225 or 232 or something like that, but for now, we'll just be conservative and say 211 stones from this campaign. And once you add all this stuff up, right, everything from the 300 million download celebration to the anniversary to this potential Kefla campaign, I mean, whatever it is, I feel like around 200 stones is reasonable to expect for the next campaign on global before the 350 million downloads. So you add all this stuff up and you get a grand final count of 5,089 Dragon Stones completely free to play in the last year on global. That averages out to like, I don't know, 450 stones per month? No, maybe not 450, but over 400 stones per month. Obviously, most of it comes from two campaigns, the anniversary, as well as the download celebration. But still, that is a whole lot of free stones, man. And then you do a little bit more math and you divide 5,089 by 50, since we get one ticket for every 50 stones spent. And we're looking at a free ticket count of 101 tickets that players who did everything in the last year, all the missions, got all the logins, completed all the new events and all that stuff, can expect to get in their boxes once this campaign begins. Now, like I said, if you're a pay-to-play player and you also bought some stones on top of all the free stones we got, then you should be expecting some more tickets. And, you know, at the same time, if you decided to take a break from the game and you didn't play for a while, or you got lazy on some of the new events, then you should probably expect a little bit less tickets. But this is the total number that everybody who did all the stuff, who was on top of things, can get for free once this campaign starts. And I think that is a pretty good number, guys. 101 is more than 10 multis. Lots of chances to pull some Dokkan Fest units and fill out your box, or potentially some LRs as well. And that is pretty much all I gotta say in today's video, guys. Before we go, actually, I do want to put out a quick disclaimer that this number, of course, is rough, right? Like, there's a chance that I missed some stuff along the way. There was a lot of data, a lot of information to go through, so the number could be a little bit higher than this. Maybe we made a few mistakes in the counting and it might be a little bit lower, but this is as close, as accurate of a number as me and Tony from Discord could give you, and we shouldn't be too far off, probably. Anyways, that is today's video, guys. For my newer players out there, if you jumped into the game at some point during the year and you missed some of this stuff, then you can just go to the part of the video where you know, you started the game and start counting from there, and that should still give you a pretty decent idea of how many stones, or how many tickets rather, you can expect to receive for free. Okay, so there you go, man. Not much else to say. The video is over. I'm glad, because I'm tired. I'm gonna go take a break, but ultimately, I think it was worth it. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. As always, if you liked today's video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, and you like what you see, then definitely hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell too, so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all my latest content. And that's it. I'm out of here. Until next time, hope you guys have a fantastic, fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Uppercut Media, signing out.